Okay, well, hello everyone. It has been quite some time since the last video I made, which I think was the Palmettos Be Balling meme that I posted. Which I wouldn't even really count that as a video, so it's probably been like almost like, I don't know, 5 months? No. I don't know. It's been since like February, I think. Anyways, so new update just dropped, and it's a pretty W update in my opinion. All the new stuff they added, including the unit rework that's going on with the USRF, seems pretty cool. Now, as you can see, I'm a member of the USRF. I'm a cadet second class. Not that that matters, though, but I do want to spend the time in this video to go over some of the new stuff added in this update. Okay, so the first thing that I want to go over is the new guns added. So, what I've seen is that they added the SR-51, the SR-60, and this X-160, I don't know, laser gun. So, and a couple few guns from the Noir pack. So, we'll go ahead. Oh, also the Sparrow. They added the Sparrow. We'll start with the SR-51. Now, what I have to say about this gun is that it's pretty freaking cool. You know, you can have it, you can build it to look like your tactard gun. You can put like nice looking attachments on it. You know, make it look like your character actually has money. Or if you're just a tactard, you know, use all this stuff. So, yeah, I mean, I feel like it's about time ATF added an AR-based weapon and all that. So it's really refreshing to see, in my opinion. But it's mainly made for the USRF, so I don't know if I'll be rocking this on my character unless I get it ICly from them. They added jungle mags, tape mags, and normal mags. But I do want to see if the jungle mag has a unique animation for it. Let me check. Okay. Oh boy. Okay. Shut up. Be quiet. Okay. So, let's check it out. Let's fire off a few shots. Alright. So, no. It does not seem to have a unique reload animation, but the gun itself is still pretty freaking sweet. So, I also know that when I was checking out the update yesterday, that you can change it to look like a Vietnam era M16, like, or M16A1. So I think if we grab the classic handguard and the classic stock, and we throw a carry handle on it, boom. Let's go ahead and put a taped mag, I guess, green handle wraps, and a green stock wrap. All right. See, what can we put on it? Oh, we could put wraps here too. So we go ahead and equip it. It just looks pretty freaking sweet. I'm definitely going to be using this on my USRF character. I mean, unless, I don't know, because I enjoy flexing on everyone with my M65, but this is just freaking cool. It's so cool. It's about time that the devs added an AR-based weapon, because they would just be way too common for you to not have. Anyways, so moving on, we have the SR-60 modular. Now, if I remember correctly, this is a DMR or sniper rifle? I think it's just a DMR. Let's see. Yeah, you have a factory mag, DMR mag, rifle stock, what's the Overwatch stock? Okay, I think that just turns it into a regular DMR. You have different barrels, so we have the Overwatch barrel. I think that turns this into a sniper rifle, this Overwatch barrel. So I guess here's the sniper variant, and then over here we have a stealth barrel, which is much shorter. Let me check and see if it fires like a DMR or if it fires more like an AR. Let me take a sec. Let's see. Okay, yeah, okay. So I'm just gonna assume this acts more like the SR-57. I don't know. But let's see, what else do we have? SR-60 modular. Let's see, here's the DMR barrel, the commander barrel, and I don't think it has its own scope. It does not. But there's two places to put attachments on. There's a rail mount. You have four different barrels to choose from, two different kinds of magazines, and two different kinds of stocks. So it's a pretty cool weapon in my opinion. Let's go ahead and switch it to the sniper variant. Let's go ahead and throw, I guess, that on it. So the sniper variant here looks pretty sick, but it's a bullpup, and I don't really like bullpups. Yeah, it functions like a DMR. It doesn't seem that accurate, though. It's trailing off from the shots a lot, so I don't know if I'd use this for IMRS. It's not like it matters. It's still a really cool gun. I really enjoy this update. Now we have the laser gun. Let's see. Laser gun. The XSR-60E Olander. Okay, so this is a laser rifle. I believe it shoots very fast. Let's go ahead and check it out. I really like the design. The design is pretty sleek, and I could see a lot of droids using this. This looks like a weapon I'd see in the hands of a lot of droids, special troopers and all that. But I'm definitely gonna use this in on my other characters if I'm allowed to. It fires pretty fast, just like the Spectre from the Covert Ops pack from last Christmas. But I don't think it's as modular as the other two USRF weapons. Let's go ahead and check that out. No, there's two attach points, one for scopes and one for a, what the hell is that? So a factory grip or a US Mark 62. Let's see what that does. Is it like a grenade launcher or lightning shot? Okay. So it's basically just a microvolt, unless this like actually kills people with it. Pretty sick. This is a very unique, very cool gun. I props to the devs because they did an amazing job with the design for these guns. They look absolutely sick. So now that's pretty much it. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the Noir weapons. So as you can see, this looks like a Thompson with a whatever mag. I have no clue what kind of magazine it is. I guess just a plate magazine. I don't know what they're called. Or a disc. Disc mag. On the top. I think it's like some kind of British rifle. Let me check it out. Weird. It looks like a weird combination of the Lewis gun and the Thompson. So you can add a scope mount for only hollow sights only. Excuse me. I'm a little sick, so please excuse me if I sound different than normal. So there's different handles. There's purple monster handles, wooden handles, plastic. So yeah, I'm sure you can try and tard this out. But it looks like there's a lot of purple monster things. Yeah, I think, well, somebody must have made this for the Ashigaru. This is definitely a gun I would see the Ashigaru using. Looks like these attachments were made perfectly to their color scheme. It doesn't look like it's working. No, it's not. Not all the attachments are loading in. But let's go ahead and shoot it a little bit. See what it's like. I'm assuming it's gonna shoot like crazy fast. Oh yeah. That's pretty awesome. I guess it's because I don't have it. Yeah, I don't have it, but it's letting me use the American 180 still, so I think that the devs want to hop on this and patch that, because I don't own the Noir pack. Let's see. I don't own the Noir pack at all, so I think that I shouldn't be able to use this. Anyways, moving on. Now we are going to move on to props, and this is my most favorite part about this update. They added so many new things, and not only that, but we're getting props from the Christmas boxes in 2021, which is pretty nice in my opinion. So we got an arcade machine, I guess. Now let's see what's next. I know we have pill boxes. So we have concrete pill boxes now, and we're only allowed to place two, which is all right. But I think this is going to be heavily used by the USRF probably. I can definitely see the USRF using a lot of these pill boxes. They look very sweet. They look very cool, and offer a lot more defense options during raids and IMRS events, in my opinion. We also have reinforced walls. So finally, we have some decent metal props. So let me go ahead and add reinforced wall. So we finally have metal walls that we can place around. And because my faction isn't really poor, and I'm gonna be honest, I'm getting really tired of just seeing scrap and wood everywhere. So especially on areas that make sense to have metal walls, where you don't want anyone getting in. So we have a reinforced slanted roof. We have a reinforced vendor wall for safe trading. We have a reinforced wall 1 and a reinforced wall 2. We also have a reinforced flat roof, which can be used for a floor. We have a reinforced doorway, a reinforced deposit hole, and then we have a reinforced pillar and a reinforced door. It's like a vault door. Awesome. This is probably my favorite part about this update, because it opens up so much more to build and roleplay in, outside of just plain scrap and wood. If you're like a more sophisticated faction, it would make sense for you to have more metallic structures to build around. And especially because Rocket Ridge and I are planning this roleplay event involving a prison roleplay in ATF, if it makes sense. Basically, how I kind of want that to go down is, basically, you have two sides. You have the prison guards and the warden, and then you have the prisoners. Now, we don't have any lore developed, but it's not going to be an alternate universe, and I kind of want to make it canon to maybe some UFF stories, probably my own, but I still can't say for sure. But it's going to happen in a secluded place on Sunrise Isles. We're going to build a prison, and we're going to have a roleplay events there, where over time the prisoners begin to develop an escape plan to escape this prison. And these prisoners haven't done anything wrong, but they're being captured to be sold on the black market, or sold off as slaves, some things like that. But there still hasn't been any lore developed soon. I'll probably make a video announcing it sometime in the near future, whenever we get more things done and our actual, how we want to go about it, actually set. But I just want to put that out there, just to, you know, give you a heads up on what's coming next, because I think I'm going to be doing a series along that. Another thing, USRF Lakeside Life. I know it's a series I really had fun making the first video, and I did make the second video, but the video footage got corrupted, so I did make a post about it on YouTube and just wrote what happened. Anyways, so with the USRF Lakeside Life, I'll be continuing that whenever I get into a USRF host or roleplay that's not just some boring patrol and whatnot. Anyways, moving further. They have added shipping container homes. So let's go ahead and clear these props here. They have added shipping containers and shipping container homes. So it's shipping container storage and shipping container vendor. So I think this is gonna make, I'm definitely adding these into Port Town for probably, especially for our slums portion of the town. It's gonna look, it looks very nice. A very creative idea too, and it's something that I've wanted to add because I really like Kingfisher Market, but I like the overall concept and design of Kingfisher Market, but I don't necessarily enjoy role-playing there. So having shipping container homes like this to put in our settlement is just wonderful. It even has a porch, a nice window. You know, I even saw one guy in Nigeria living in a home like this when I was on vacation. Now, moving further, there is a parking garage subzone it is massive. It is huge. So, hold on. I guess we'll just put it there. So, inside this parking garage is a huge subzone to build stuff. And there's two garage rooms to put cars and stuff. I know a lot of UFFs are going to be using these for bases. Not only that, but it even has a functioning light switches, so you don't have to waste props on lighting up the room. And it's still fairly dark, it's still pretty dark. But this place looks amazing. I can just see a lot being done with something like here, right like here. And especially for the bigger factions, they can actually have maybe a designated place to have a car depot. I don't know. But let's see, what else do we have in here? I'll do a review on some of the stuff that I haven't bought yet in another video. But so far I'm just going over with what I got. They have added a tent, a FEMA tent, I think. So, I'm stuck. I can't move. Let me out. Okay. A FEMA tent. So, a more, I guess, sophisticated kind of tent. Probably used for medical purposes. So, let's go ahead and open the door. Shut it. So, I guess. I don't know what a FEMA test tent does, though. let me take a moment to look that up. And see, like, what it would be used for. I'm assuming medical purposes or research. I guess they're just disaster relief tents. So you could use this as a home. I'm assuming like organization, like faction, humanitarian aid factions will have field days with these builds. So what else? I know they added a bunch of Christmas props, but it's not Christmas, so I'm really not all that excited about going over them. But let's go ahead and do so. So we have different Christmas presents, and I think they're based off of the mystery box designs. I think I'd have to check, but probably. I think so. Yeah, I think they're no. Never mind, they're not. But we have different kinds of. We have 8 different kinds of Christmas presents. And yeah. We have a Christmas tree. Does it light up? No. We have Christmas tree rug. We even have Christmas milk and cookies. There's more Christmas props, but I can't seem to find them. I don't know if they've released all of them yet, but so far there seems to be about 10 Christmas props. They've added night vision goggles. Now, with these, I don't know if we'd be allowed to use them ICLE or if they're just for decoration. I mean, why would it make sense to just leave a perfectly good pair of quad nods on the ground or on a table when you can just pick them up and put them on your head? I don't know. They've also added picture frames, so we can now put pictures up of things. That's a pretty sweet picture there, you know? And this picture speaks the truth. This picture speaks everything that you should do. And I don't ask for subscribers that much, but listen, we're getting pretty close to 1,000, and I just kind of want to hit that goal now, which is why I'm starting to make videos again. I'm going to be honest, I've really taken my channel for granted for how far I've come as a YouTuber. Even though I haven't really put in my best effort, it's just insane that I'm still gaining subscribers even when I'm not posting videos. So I'll just take a moment to say thank you for all your love and support. And I'm still seeing fans and people who are using my rig still out and about months after I've put up these videos. One guy today at Black Mountain walked up to me and said, "Hey, you copied that watch from Regenza." And I had to turn around and tell him, "I am Regenza." But yeah. Also, I'm thinking about making more Deepwoken content. I have gotten back into Deepwoken. It's a pretty fun game. You're probably going to think I'm a nerd for it. I probably am. I mean, I play ATF, so I might as well be a nerd. But I'm definitely going to be making some Deepwoken videos if I can get to a point to where I'm good enough to make it entertaining to watch, because I really suck. A travel case, I think that's new. They added a Trekker camper, and I can build as many of these as I want. So you can have an entire settlement of Trekker camper vans. It's pretty sweet. I think this would also be good for, like, I can definitely see people like role playing this as like a transport thing. I don't know, but one of the best things I think about the props is the addition of wanted posters. Finally, you no longer have to just stay and look in CRH to see wanted posters. So can we just add player? How do you? Oh yeah, you can add a character. Oh crap. Okay, we can go ahead and we can add a character too. So we can go ahead and throw my name in there. Set. Failed to update clipboard. Oh. What? Oh, okay, here. Character element added. Okay, I guess that picture's there. But as you can see, my character is on there. I can add text above the show wanted and how much money I'm wanted for, and all that stuff. So that's pretty cool. So definitely, I really enjoy the wanted signs. You can only put up eight per person can only be put up. All right, guys, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If there's anything I missed about this update, please let me know in the comment section. I am aware that I missed the Sophia toy items, the sewage subzone, and the 38 special from the Noir pack. But other than that, I think I covered pretty much everything. Thank you for coming to watch the video. If you liked it, hit the like button down below. Give me a nice little subscription if you really enjoy my content. But yeah, I'm gonna be trying to upload more regularly, sticking to my regular schedule of one video per week, uploads on every Sunday. And yeah, thanks for watching. I'll catch y'all in the next one. See ya.